Well, hello there. I hope everyone's doing okay. Here we are on a Saturday, April 12th, 2020, at 8:31 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And at the moment, we're facing west. And that tiny little dot there is the planet Venus. Now at the moment, we have two cameras running. So we have the wide field of view with the full-frame Canon EOS R camera, just so we can see the color of the sky and the trees and such. And over here on the other camera, we have the Nikon P1000 at full zoom. Now we'll check the settings. All right, the ISO is at 1600, okay. Now, we're gonna try that trick of putting the six-stop ND filter on to cut down on the brightness. If I don't drop it again. Wow, we lost it. Now then. Too dark? What? Okay, for some reason this six-stop filter is too dark and it totally blackened it out. So, could try. Okay, so that didn't work. So we just change the shutter speed. Oh my. All right, that's cool. We can see the face of Venus. Bit of a crescent there. And I don't see anything else out here. No, I take that back. I can see Sirius now over in the to our left in the southwest. But it's still a bit too bright out to see anything else. All right, you know what? That's good enough for Venus. Okay, that's one thing I hate about this Nikon P1000. It has such terrible low light. And I have the exposure up as far as it'll go, and I still can't see a flicker of light where Sirius should be. I mean, this is beyond ridiculous. Nothing. Just blackness. So if you ever wonder why I don't like taking this camera out anymore, this is one of the reasons right here. And it should be right around there, but not a flicker of light. You little bastard, you. There's nothing else I can do. I can't brighten up the scene any more than it is. Rawr. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Well, at least on the other camera, it looks like a bit of Orion is starting to show. We have Venus over to the right, Sirius far to the left, and Betelgeuse is right near the top. Oh, Nikon P1000 is really ticking me off. So, I'm not gonna mess with it anymore. And I'm going to go over to the other camera. And I have a wide angle lens on here, so I really can't go too far. Actually, we can see Orion, and I believe over to the right above that tree is Aldebaran. Now, Betelgeuse is shining quite brightly up there. So it looks pretty good. Orion's belt. The nebula. The two bottom stars of Orion. There's Sirius. And Aldebaran and Venus. And by the tip of those tree branches is Pleiades. So since we're being shut out on the P1000 because I can't see crap on it, I might change up and go get the Canon 80D. Let's do that. All right, I'll be back. So here we are now on the Canon 80D and the Tamron 18-400 lens, and we can see the settings, which I'll shut off if I can remember where all the buttons are. I wish they were uniform info. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that damn security light screws up my northwest sky, but then so do the trees, so. All right, that one in the middle should be Aldebaran, that orange one. Get her in focus. I'd like to try to get, and I think it's too late for the Pleiades that might be in the trees. Yeah. I think that's them over there. Shoot. No, I don't think I have the in-camera digital zoom on. Let me check. There we go. And I don't have the right size filter out here. Doggone it. All right, so there we have an overexposed Venus. Oh yeah, I've had a lot of people asking about Comet Atlas, but I wanted to let you guys know I won't be able to see or film it, not from my location, because of all the obstacles in the way, the security light, trees, houses, everything else. So I don't have a view of the northwest, north, northeast, or anything like that. And the reports are recently that the comet may be breaking up, so I don't know if it's going to put on a good show or not. But I hope wherever you are, you have a chance to see it, even though I can't. Now Ray's astrophotography channel, he has this huge telescope, and he was able to capture it. He has some great footage of it. And the awesome setup he has, oh my goodness. So I'll try to remember to leave a link down below so you can go check it out. Check out the green monster. So far, this is a bust, huh? It is cool though, you can see Sirius, Venus, and Orion. Now the Canon 80D doesn't have the greatest of low light either, but it's a hell of a lot more. Whoa, what the hell is that? Okay. Okay, so that overexposed orange and white blob is Betelgeuse, the top left of Orion. Orion's belt. And on this camera, I really can't get the Orion Nebula either. Oh well. Alright, it's not going to come out very well, but that's the best we're going to get. Because the camera I'd like to use is over there. Okay. So, we missed out on the Pleiades. Alright, and there we go. That's our flashy dog star over there in the south. Actually, in the southwest now. And there's some clouds and stuff going over top of it. We have rain incoming and bad storms on Monday, and I think yet another week of rain. What a pain in the butt. But there we go. Oh my. This was not a good night for me. I thought things would go swimmingly with having two cameras out here to get the views I wanted, you know, with the wide view and then the zoomed in on the P1000. Oh well. Anyway, that's gonna have to do it. And so I'm gonna wish you all a great one. Be safe wherever you are in this crazy ass world. Take care, and if you celebrate Easter, well, happy Easter to you. Bye from Ohio. It's now 9:11 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. Bye now. That's done. That looks terrible.